Say the obvious. There's always things that we think we have to do. There's things we want to do. And there's things we should do. And my reality of living each day with God has become more one of experiencing what I can do, as opposed to what most people say I ought to do. You see, what I can do is I can start my day in a very real and personal way with God. I can get up and rush to a shower, get my hyper metabolism going, and get wound up scrubbing my face and getting cleaned up, shaving, drinking my coffee, getting excited about what I have to do. Or I could take a moment to pause, to slow down, to even listen, to see if God might say something to me today. Has God spoken to you yet? When He does, I hope you learn to listen and not just rush off doing what you think you have to do, but learning to do what you can do. It came to pass after a while that the brook dried up because there had been no rain in the land. 1 Kings 17:7, streams in the desert. Week after week, with unfaltering and steadfast spirit, Elijah watched the dwindling brook. Often tempted to stagger through unbelief, but refusing to allow his circumstances to come between himself and God. Unbelief sees God through circumstances, as we sometimes see the sun shorn of its rays through smoky air. But faith puts God between itself and circumstances and looks at Him through them. But faith puts God between itself and circumstances and looks at them, the circumstances, through God. And so the dwindling brook became a silver thread, and the silver thread stood presently in pools at the foot of the largest boulders, and the pools shrank. The birds fled, the wild creatures of field and forest came no more to drink, and the brook was dry. Only then, to his patient and unwavering spirit, the word of the Lord came, saying, "Arise, get thee to Zarephath." Most of us would have gotten anxious and worn with planning long before that. We should have ceased our songs as soon as the streamlet caroled less musically over its rocky bed, and with harps swinging on the willows. We should have paced to and fro ere the brook was dry, and we should have devised some plan and contingency, some emergency backup plan that we had of our own, asking God's blessing on it, and then running off to do what we know we should do, and would have started off elsewhere. God often does extricate us, because His mercy endures forever. But if we only had waited to see the unfolding of His plans, we should never have found ourselves landed in such a mire and maze of figuring out what His will is. We should never have been compelled to retrace our steps with so many tears of shame. Wait patiently, but wait. Wait on the Lord. I know it's easy always to react to something. Somebody smacks us, and we don't want to know why he smacked us. We want to react and smack back. Or someone confronts us, and we don't want to know why or how they confront us. We want to defend ourselves. We want to exercise our rights of defense. But did you know that there's a new way of responding to emergencies? The first response is to evaluate. It says to stop Don't rush right in. But look at the situation and evaluate it. Then act accordingly. When you are faced by your day, you can rush off on your way. You could do your own thing. You can have your own personal will, and God will, you know, give it to you. He'll let you do it. He'll give you the authority, and you could go running around in circles, you know, playing little games with what you think you own. Or you could do what Jesus did in the Garden of Gethsemane, when after knowing what God's will was, rest, be refreshed by angels, and accept God's will by hearing what he had to say and then doing it. It's a pretty simple way to live. It's not very confusing. And you know what? It's a whole lot more rewarding. Because you may not get riches and glory. You may not get wealth beyond measure. You may not get anything else except for one thing I'm going to tell you that will change your life and will make you unique among men. God himself just might talk to you direct. When he does, you are blessed.